Hey guys, welcome back. It's Crystal. So today I'm going to be decluttering all of these makeup brushes here. I've been just kind of going through my brush collection. I have so many makeup brushes. It's kind of ridiculous. So I've been decluttering and these are all the ones that I know that I want to get rid of. I do need to go through my brushes again to kind of weed through some more maybe, but these are the ones that I know for a fact that I'm gonna get rid of. I'm gonna pass these down probably to my family member. My cousin's living with us right now and she said she needed some new makeup brushes, so I'll let her have first dibs and then my mom is next. They usually like to dig through the products that I'm going to declutter, unless I'm gonna sell them, obviously, but I do apologize if I sound kind of nasally or congested, because I am. I actually was diagnosed with an ear infection last night and it does feel a lot better today. But I can't really hear too well out of that ear, and I sound a little bit congested. So I hope you guys don't mind, but let's go ahead and weed through all these brushes. All right, so the first one here is a Sephora brush. It's an old brush. It's a mineral powder brush, number 45. This used to be great for foundation and for like powder foundations, but I have so many other ones that I just figured I would get rid of this one. My cousin would probably like this one. I have another Sephora brush here. This is an old one as well. It's the Airbrush in number 55. This one I used to like to apply foundation as well, but I like something a little bit more dense, something a little bit more like this one. So this one I'm going to get rid of. It'd be good for like powder or bronzing, but I don't need it, so I'm gonna get rid of that. I have an e.l.f. brush here. This is a contouring brush. I just don't use these brushes. I have quite a few different ones and I really just don't use them, so I'm going to get rid of that. Sorry if I repeat myself in this video. This one's by Makeup Geek and I just never use this. It's the angled contour brush. I mean, I'm not gonna use this. I like something bigger and fluffier to contour with, so that's a pass. And it sheds a lot. This is a duo fiber face brush from Crown Brush. It is the C404 brush. I just don't use duo fibers that much. And if I do, I think I prefer something that's bigger and fluffier. This one's just kind of small. And then I'm not too crazy about fan brushes, honestly. So I'm gonna get rid of quite a few, maybe like three or four of them. This one is by So Susan. I think I got this in a BoxyCharm box. This one's a pass, as well as this one. It's the Eco Tools one. I do have a newer Eco Tools one? I think I do. I can't remember, but I'm not gonna use this one. It's older. Actually, I like this one better than the real thin ones. This one's a little bit more dense and fluffy. So if I'm gonna use a fan brush for highlighting, it would be something more like this. But I think I have this one in the newer, like Feral and stuff. So I'm gonna keep that one versus this one. This is by Vasanti. It is a flat paddle brush. You could use this for face mask or foundation. I really don't use these flat paddle brushes. This is Real Techniques. And it's the pointed foundation brush. I mean, it's so tiny. I'm not gonna use it, never do use it. This one is a Borghese 102 duo fiber blending brush. Again, I think I like something a little bit bigger and fluffier when it comes to a duo fiber brush. This one's maybe about medium sized, so I'm gonna pass on that. So this is an e.l.f. Ultimate Kabuki brush. It's really, really smooth and soft. I just don't use it. This would be good for like body bronzing or powder all over the body or even all over the face, but I just never grab for this, even though it's extremely soft. I'm just gonna go ahead and pass that along. And I'm sorry if my fingernails look so dry. They are. I need to like paint them, push the cuticles back, moisturize. They're looking horrid right now, so don't mind my nails. All right, so I have quite a few Eco Tools brushes I'm getting rid of. This one's the Eco Tools by Alicia Silverstone. It is so old. This is probably like, some of these are some of the first brushes I ever started using. And it's just like a powder or blush brush. And I'm gonna pass that along. I have another Eco Tools brush. I already own another one of these. For some reason I thought, I need a backup. I love this brush so much, but I don't need to. So I'm gonna get rid of this one. It's the Stippling brush. But I do like this brush, so I do have another one I'm going to keep. Another fan brush. This one's by Sonia Kashuk. It came in a set. I'm gonna pass that along. And this is like a, I think this is a Studio Tools like powder brush, and I actually do like it, but I have other ones I love more, and I just don't need it. Here's another one of those Eco Tools blush brushes. Don't need them. I had two of them and I'm gonna pass that one. There's another Eco Tools brush. This one is a like flat top kabuki looking brush and this is good for like foundation, but I have so many others. I'm gonna pass that. This is a Borghese brush. It is the round foundation brush in 104. I do not like this. Never used it. It would be good to blend out concealer, I think, because it has a pointy tip, but I just don't like it. And then this one here is by Sonia Kashuk. I do like this line of brushes. I like the handles and how they have this nice grip here. This one is like a foundation brush. I just don't like it. It's a little bit too small for me. I like something a little bit bigger. And I'm just gonna pass that on. This is a Morphe M516 brush. Not too much of a fan of this. It has like a straight cut. It is good for crease work, but I just prefer other ones more. Here's another Borghese brush. And these all came in a set a long, long, long time ago. This is a 200 Eye Powder Fluffer brush. It would be good for like blending out crease work and stuff, but I have other ones I like more. This is an e.l.f. Small Stipple brush. And you know what? The ferrule is actually coming off, so I'm just gonna get rid of this. All right, this is a Laura Geller like sponge tip double-ended brush. I think it came with a highlighter or something. I don't like it. Never used it. This is another flat paddle by Ulta. It's one of the really old brushes. This one is by Target Up and Up. I used to love this for a foundation, but I have so many other ones I love more, so I'm gonna get rid of this. This one's by Sonia Kashuk. It sheds a lot. Do you see all those hairs shedding? Like, look at this. Do you see all these hairs? Oh my gosh, I'm gonna get rid of this. Here's another brush. I think it's by Studio Tools. Good for foundation or bronzing, like cream contour, cream bronzing, but I don't need it. Another flat paddle brush from Real Techniques. This is a e.l.f. brush. On these, they don't have the names, so I don't know what this one's called, but it has a little divot there. It's like for contouring, cream contouring. I don't like these too much. I don't ever use them. This one is an e.l.f. angled blush brush. I used to like this, but I have other blush brushes I use over this one. This is from CVS, like 500 years ago. It's the Essence of Beauty line contour control. I used to love this, but I have so many other brushes I like in place of that. This is an IT Cosmetics double-ended Heavenly Luxe No Tug dual eyeshadow brush. I just never use dual-ended brushes. I just don't like to store them. I just think they're a hassle. This is a Makeup Geek rounded blush brush. Super small. I prefer other brushes way over this one. This is another one that sheds. Look at all this hair. I hate brushes that shed like that. This is a Royal Care Cosmetics pointed brush, and I just don't use it. This is a Lorac double-ended eyeshadow brush. It came with a palette, I'm sure. I don't use this. This is another Borghese brush, 203 domed smudge brush. It's just too stiff. I don't care for that. This is another Borghese brush. It is a 201 eyeshadow brush. I could keep this, but I just have so many others. So this is another Borghese brush, 202 angled eye contour brush. Just getting rid of that. This is a Bella Pierre Cosmetics like kabuki brush. I don't really use these kabuki brushes. I think I have one or two that I'm keeping, but for the most part, I really just never use them. I don't like how they have a short handle, so I'm gonna get rid of this one. It is very, very soft. I got this in a BoxyCharm, and I do like it. It works well, but I never use these. I never grab for them. These two are from Chanel. They came with one of their, each one came with a highlighter from Chanel. No, yeah, wait. No, it came, is it Dior? I think it came with a Dior, actually, not Chanel. Came with Dior highlighters, and I'm just gonna get rid of these. This is a really old Equal Tools Duo Fiber Kabuki brush. It has a nice handle on it, but I don't need it. I have a ton of eye brushes coming up here. So this is a Pixie Beauty Kabuki brush. Came with a set, like a bronzer or something. I'm gonna get rid of that. This is another Sonia Kashuk brush. I washed all of these. This one was sitting in the box funny, so it has a weird shape to it, but it's usually pretty fluffy, but it sheds and, does it shed? Yeah, it does shed. So it sheds and I just have other ones I like better. Okay, I have a bunch of eye brushes here. So this one's by Sonia Kashuk as well. It's just super old, good for crease work. This is a double-ended Stila brush, number 30. I like this side. It's a little bit pokey though. It's not the softest, and I'm just gonna get rid of that. This is a Face Secrets eye contour. I used to love this for especially the brow bone color because it has a nice point to it. You can get right up there in the brows, but I don't need it. And this is super old. So this one's an Essence of Beauty crease brush. It's more like a pencil brush, actually. I don't think I washed all the eye brushes. Those are actually dirty. So I'm getting rid of all of these toothbrush brushes. I did a review on these. I just prefer my regular brushes over these types of brushes. And I like the bigger ones versus the small ones, but I think they're a pain to wash. I don't enjoy washing them. They're just kind of hard to get all the product out and like to squeeze them dry. I just don't grab towards these. So I'm gonna get rid of all of these. One set I purchased, one was sent to me. So yeah, I'm just gonna get rid of both sets. All right, so I have these two silly sponges. I did a review on these. These were sent to me and I just didn't like them that much. I prefer a beauty blender or a brush over these. I think it just applies better than these do. So I'm gonna get rid of those. All right, so here's a flat paddle brush from Sonia Kashuk, getting rid of this. All right, so I'm gonna get rid of all of these like eyeliner brushes. There's these ones from L'Oreal that came with their gel eyeliners. I do really like these. These used to be my favorite, but I just decided to get rid of all these short handled brushes like this. I don't know, I was in the mood to declutter. Some of these I really like, but I do have bigger ones that I like with a longer handle. So I'm going to get rid of all these small ones. And then this one is like a Real Techniques. This is a silicone liner brush. I don't like this at all. This came in a set that was sent to me. And I like all the other brushes, but these, I don't like these eyeliner brushes. They're too flimsy and they just flare out. Like, I just don't get a good precise line when I use these for eyeliner. This one is an old one from Sonia Kashuk. Just getting rid of that. There's a couple Sigma ones in here. Like this one I really like. It's the EO5, but I have the full size, so I don't need to keep this one. And then like I have this one from Milani that came with a gel liner. Like these came with the Maybelline gel liners, and I really like these as well, but I'm not gonna keep them. All right, so I have this really weird brush here. It's by Royal & Langnickel. I think this came in a set from BoxyCharm. I just don't use this. I don't see anything I'll use it for, so I'm gonna get rid of that. I have all these random ones. These are like by Studio Tools, and I used to love these, but I just never use them anymore. I have so many brushes. I know I keep repeating myself, but it's true. This is a Face Secret Studio Blender. This is an e.l.f. contour brush. Just never use them. This one's from Ulta. It's one of their really old ones. This is a good brush. I just never use those really big ones. And same with this one. It's the same as one I just showed you. This one's from It Cosmetics. It's a double-ended brush. I'm never gonna use it. This one's by Zoeva. And I really do like this, like to blend out concealer, but I have a full size, so I don't need this one. It's the Concealer Buffer 142. These here are by Essence of Beauty, like crease brushes, lid brushes, pencil brush. I just don't need any of these, so I'm gonna get rid of all of those. Another double-ended brush from, I think, Studio Tools. This one's an Estee Lauder lip brush. I just never really use lip brushes. And I do have a couple. I mean, once in a blue moon, I might, but for the most part, I just don't. Here's another like eyeliner brush from Real Techniques that I don't like. This one's by Sonia Kashuk. Here's another from Sonia Kashuk. It's just kind of a weird thick tip. Here's like a angled one from Real Techniques. I just think it's way too thick for like eyebrows or eyeliner. Here's another liner brush that I don't care for. These are all like angled eyeshadow brushes, which I do really like, but some of these have short handles and I just don't see the need to keep them. And I just have some others, so I'm just gonna get rid of these. There's Eco Tools, e.l.f., Bare Minerals, and Studio Tools brushes in here. Then just have a variety of ones in here. Sorry, I'm going a little quicker. I just don't wanna bore you to death with brushes. It's like a crease brush. These are from Sonia Kashuk, Royal Langnickel. It's like a pointed. This would be good for the outer corner, but I'm just not gonna keep it. I like something a little fluffier. And then just some from Studio Tools, like really small detail brushes. And then here's one from Revlon. These are actually both from Revlon. And these work well, I just don't wanna keep them. And this is another Studio Tools brush. Here's a double-ended one from Anastasia. It came in a palette that I don't really use. And here's one from Sigma. It's the E25, which I love, but I just don't feel the need to keep this. I mean, I guess I could keep these small ones like in my makeup bag. Oof. Maybe I'll keep this actually and just put it in my purse. Cause once in a while I might take my eyeshadows with me to work if my eyes are watering. It always messes up my makeup and sometimes I need like a little brush. So maybe I'll just keep that one. Maybe this one as well. It's a little Sigma brush right here. And then here's another double-ended from Stila. And just some random ones. This is like a lip brush or something. It has like a sharpener on the other end, or maybe it's like a smudger brush from Eco Tools. and just some randoms. I'm just not gonna use any of these, so I'm gonna get rid of them. All right, guys, so those were all the makeup brushes that I am going to declutter. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I love you guys. Have a great day. Bye.